You can see that the vehicles and train are moving on the bridge. This movement develops stress in all the sections of a particular element. If you consider a single column of the bridge, you will observe the loading pattern for the column changes with the movement of vehicle. Let us consider one element of that column. An element subjected to complex loading systems develop the stresses sigma xx, sigma yy, sigma zz in three principal directions, x, y and z. Also, there would be six components of shear stresses in these three directions in this element. Plane stress. In this case, surface in z direction is taken as free from stresses. Therefore, the stresses are considered only in x and y directions. We do not consider the stresses in z direction, assuming z direction to be free from stresses. Stresses considered only in directions x and y are called plane stresses. Normal stress. Stress perpendicular to an imaginary plane is called as normal stress. Let us cut or consider any plane at an angle theta. The stress acting perpendicular to this imaginary plane is called normal stress. Principal stress. It is normal stress acting on a plane on which no shear stress is acting. If the XY axis are rotated, various stress components applicable will change. There is an angle theta at which normal stresses will be a maximum or minimum, and there will be zero shear stress. These normal stresses are called the principal stresses. Mohr circle. Mohr's circle is a simple graphical method of showing stresses developed within a member which is subject to loading. This method finds out normal and shear stresses at different orientation of the plane. To understand the procedure of drawing Mohr's circle, let us consider a stress system of two principal stresses, sigma x and sigma y, and normal stress, sigma n, at an angle theta. Using some suitable scale, mark OL and OM from the origin O equal to sigma x and sigma y respectively on the x-axis. Bisect LM at N. With N as center and NL as radius, draw a circle. From point N, draw a line NP at an angle 2 theta. This line is drawn in the anti-clockwise direction. From P, drop a perpendicular PQ on the axis OX. PQ will represent tau. And OQ will represent sigma N. Now from the Mohr's diagram, NP is equal to NL is equal to sigma X minus sigma Y upon 2. Tau is equal to PQ is equal to NP sine 2 theta is equal to sigma x minus sigma y upon 2 into sine 2 theta. Similarly, sigma n is equal to OQ is equal to ON plus NQ is equal to sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus sigma x minus sigma y by 2 cos 2 theta. Also, from circle tau is maximum when 2 theta is equal to 90 degree or theta is equal to 45 degree and tau max is equal to sigma x minus sigma y upon 2. Also, resultant stress is OP is equal to under root sigma n square plus tau square. Obliquity is equal to tan phi is equal to tau divided by sigma n.